Hey guys, Max the Intern here, and this is episode 3, I believe, of our vlog, our video series. And in this episode, we're going to be talking about my first event that I went to, Motorama. That was an awesome event, and we'll sit down with my boss, Andrew Ziegler, and kind of go through our event schedule and how many events we go to every year and what they're kind of based around. And we'll show you some pictures and videos from Motorama, and I think that'll be about it for this episode, so keep in touch and watch till the end. Okay. Hey guys, Max the Intern here, and today we're going to be talking about my first event I went to, which was one of the coolest things I've got to do with the Horizon so far. So we went to, or I went to Motorama in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, which from headquarters in Champaign here is about a 14-hour drive. So it was a long car ride there, but it was well worth it once we got there. A lot of the stuff that goes on is Motorama. There's a whole lot of stuff. They have a giant car show. They have motocross or arena cross races, go-kart races. They have a 10-scale and A-scale RC car racetracks. And they have crawling, or RC scaling crawling tracks, demolition derbies. They have battle bots, and that's about as much as you can fit into one giant building at Motorama. So the Motorama building is about, like, I think it's a mile of building all put together where they host this event at. It's one of the coolest things I've ever gotten to do. We had a big display in front of the car show, and we'll show you some pictures of the display of what the event was kind of focused around. And then some demos we got to do. Before the arena cross races, we got to drive fifth scales, 5Ts, DUXLs, MTXL on the arena cross track. So we got to jump some of the arena cross jumps, and that was really cool. We hooked up an American flag to a drone, and we did the national anthem with the drone. We hooked it up and flew it above everybody. That was pretty cool. We got to sit and watch some of the RC races and a lot of stuff like that. We demoed out front in front of the Motorama for a while. So it was one of the most fun events I've been to. It's a two-day event, and they put about 50,000 people through the event in 2 days. So it can get hectic at times, but it's pretty awesome. If you're in that area of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania, I would really suggest going to that event. It's a pretty awesome event, and I hope to see you guys there next year.
national anthem.
Hey guys, Max the Intern here, and today we're with my boss, Andrew Ziegler. No, you're not my boss. Okay.
Yes,
So today we're going to be talking about our road trip schedule and all the events we do through the year. So what's kind of the basis and how many events do we do a year?
So we do around 70-ish events. 70 events. That's not including any of the like TLR races,
okay,
or any of the fly-ins or any of the fun flies that we send team members to. So
Okay. You
could probably almost add another 45,
wow,
50
wow
events that Okay. We have some sort of representation at, and then some events we don't even know about, team guys still go to and participate in. So quite a few.
Cool. So are most of those like air events, or are they all surface events?
It's kind of a mix. One thing that we've been changing up a little bit is the in-industry events, like we used to have iHobby and RCX.
Mm-hmm.
Those shows have kind of gone away. They used to be where everybody would go to kind of see the models.
What's
and,
new.
And yeah, what was new is the first time they'd be able to see it
before
it hit the shops. But now with the internet, it's as soon as we go live with something, bam, everybody's got
everybody
it.
Sees it.
They've seen it, they've seen video, they hear it, it's there.
It's
you
all
know
new. Yeah.
The only thing they can't do is hold it in their hands. So we've been kind of refocusing and doing still the shows that are happening within the industry, but then we're reaching to new consumers outside the industry.
Okay, cool.
Like full scale off-road shows, like the off-road or the foil jamborees we do, full scale air shows like we're going to be doing this weekend and this all next week at
so
Oshkosh.
What event is coming up this weekend?
It's Oshkosh, and so it starts on Monday. We got a crew going up Sunday,
and
they'll be there all week until the
Sunday to Sunday.
Sunday to Sunday.
Poor guys.
So, and they'll probably see, probably come through the booth, probably around 100,000, 120,000
wow
people maybe.
Wow. Yeah,
it's a lot. There's a lot of people, a lot of stuff, a lot of airplanes.
Yeah.
And it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of work at the same time.
Okay. So most of the events these go to, I know I've been to Motorama myself, and people see these awesome cars, and a lot of events you can't buy them at. So around how many, what's the percentage of events that we have like retailers at?
Our main events that we do, the in-industry and the ones where we're trying to reach new consumers, we will definitely sell at. We try to partner with a local retailer no matter where we go. So if we're doing a Try Me or something, they can try it, they can buy it.
Cool.
It's kind of frustrating if you try something, oh, you really want it, can I buy it? We don't
and
have
it's not
it
there. Yeah.
You know, it's one thing if we sell out them, but if we never even offered it to begin with, it's kind of
right
frustrating. We want to get those people to have that experience and to be able to take that experience home with them.
Okay, what next?
Now he's thinking, what are the questions that he
asked? Yep. Intern ran out of questions.
I got some questions for you.
Oh, great.
So as an intern, since you know you've been doing this new video series, people probably want to know what your role is when you go to shows. So you've gone to Motorama, Horizon RC Fest. What have been some of your roles?
So when I went to Motorama and we were at RC Fest, I mostly handled the demos at the RC event, or the Motorama. I was handling the crawler demo. And then when we'd go into the arena cross area, I was driving the fifth scales at the...
So Max got the opportunity to drive, it was a 5T?
5T.
A 5T in front of almost, I want to say, 8,900 people, almost 9,000, 10,000 people.
Yeah.
In front of a packed audience, and you did a pretty good job.
Yeah, we were hitting motocross jumps with a fifth scale.
And I was down on the track, and you didn't hit me, thankfully.
No.
Probably not a good idea for the intern to hit his boss with a fist skill.
He's
vehicle
easy to see though, because he's a...
I'm a big target.
Yeah, he's so a good like 5'19" tall. So.
Yeah. Okay. Whatever.
Did I get it right?
That's well. I'm not doing that.
Okay. Right,
but yeah, pretty close. Pretty close.
Okay.
What's your favorite part about going to events?
Getting to interact with all the people and get their engagement and how they like the product, what new stuff they'd like to see, how they use the product, if they're racing it, if they're bashing it, jumping off jumps, if they're more into surface cars or flying helicopters and planes and stuff like that.
That's always been one of the biggest pleasures, I guess you could say, that I get out of going to shows and events is actually hearing from people. Either they were at the same event last year and they bought something and had a great experience with it and they want to buy more, or just tell us about the experience. It's pretty cool to see how they've taken that product and kind of put it into their own life and how they use it. And everybody's a little bit different. And, you know, they kind of catch that RC bug. And you're like, well, we're glad that we were able to provide that opportunity for them to try it out in the first place. So
we're talking about all these shows and how we get all these cool products to the shows. So how do we get the product to the shows?
Well, it kind of depends on the show. Some of the larger in-industry stuff that we still do, we'll pack crates. We've got big wooden crates that we put all the display product in and all the actual structure we build in, and we'll ship those wherever it might be, West Coast, East Coast, wherever. Mm-hmm. If it's a closer show and it's not a bunch of structure, we've got three trailers that we have.
Oh, wow.
So the road trip trailer, the big team trailer, and the small team trailer. We'll just load those things up and drive to wherever. So all the road trip events, the road trip events that we do, like the Four Wheel Jamborees and Oshkosh, we'll just load up the van and trailer and hit the road.
And that's if you guys have ever been to events, that's the van and trailer you see at all the events.
So yep.
We'll put a picture of it now. Okay.
Maybe.
Yeah. Hopefully my editing skills are that good.
What other questions you got for me? I guess I'll take this opportunity to ask you out there who's watching this. This is what, fourth episode? How many?
Third
episode. What kind of stuff would you like to see Max do? Mm-hmm. What questions do you have to ask of Max? And then maybe one of your future episodes is just answering all those questions that everybody has.
Do a Q&A episode?
Yeah, because I think a lot of people are pretty excited and interested of what you actually do as an intern here, because, you know, being involved with social media here at Horizon for a long time, it's people that get the inside look, and you get to see a lot of stuff that people would love to see.
Yeah.
That you're sworn to secrecy to.
Yep.
But,
well, we have this new... Can't say
almost
it.
Almost got you. But, you know, for them to kind of see Horizon through your eyes, I guess, as an intern, what your experiences are. I'm sure there's a lot of questions out there that they'd love to ask, and some of you probably won't be able to answer, but still at the same time. So if you do have any questions or suggestions, just put them down below, and we can probably do a future episode of Max the Intern Q&A session.
Yeah,
probably. Answering all those questions.
I'll sit at my desk and answer them all.
So what else you got? Max will probably be attending some more shows in the future, just depending on his school schedule, because summer break's almost over and Max has got to go back to school, but he'll still be an intern here putting some time in, so hopefully we can keep this segment going as well.
Motorama would be fun. Motorama would be great again.
I think somebody
maybe
wants to go to Motorama again. It's a fun show. It's a lot of work. It's a long trip.
Yeah. Alright. So that's about all I got for you.
Cool.
So if you guys have any more questions for myself or Mr. Ziegler here.
Make it really difficult ones for him.
No. Please don't. So, just drop those in the comments, and I'll be sure to get to those and tell Andy here if he has any questions or answers to them. So, see you guys later. Here we go.
My head's cut off.
It'll fit in the bar.
I'll have gloves.
I'll have pants.
Look at that hood, it's ugly though. You're not supposed to trip, man.